Hey guys, thanks so much for watching this video. I hope you know that as a band, our heart is to write songs that don't just simply sound good or are fun to listen to, but point us to God, that remind us of who He is and what He's done for us. And so when we wrote this song Once For All, before picking up an instrument or picking up a pen, we first began to read the Word of God, looking for something that was worth writing about. And so we found ourselves in Romans 8. And so what I wanted to do right now is to first read Romans 8 and then talk about that, so that when we're listening to this song, we're not just singing a bunch of random lyrics or listening to a cool song, but that we're truly understanding what we're singing about. So let's look here in Romans 8, starting in verse 31. It says this: "What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, and who is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are being killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No, in all things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord." And what I love about this passage and why we wrote about this passage is that it's such a powerful thing to understand that God is on our side, that regardless of who thinks what about us, if people judge us or condemn us, that God is for us. You know, back in the day, I used to play soccer a lot. I kind of grew up playing soccer. And as I got older, every year we'd have to try out to make the soccer team, right? We'd have a week long of tryouts and we would spend all week running drills, playing games, trying to impress the coaches, trying to impress the other players, and hoping to be able to make the team. And, you know, there are all sorts of opinions circulating about the other players, right? So we were thinking, well, I think I'm better than this guy, or I hope I'm better than that guy, or man, this guy's really good, or all these guys are really good. I hope I'm good enough to make this team, right? But in reality, even with all of those opinions circulating, there was only one opinion that truly mattered, and that was the coach's opinion. He was the one who decided who makes the team and who doesn't. And that's what Paul is trying to tell us in Romans 8, that it's God's opinion that matters about us. And he demonstrated what he thinks about us when Jesus came and died on the cross for our sins. You see, what's crazy is that in reality, we all deserve judgment. We all deserve condemnation. In Romans 3:23, it says, "All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." That means neither myself nor you deserve to be in relationship with a perfect and holy God. But yet God showed us his love and his mercy when he came for us when we didn't deserve it. And so as we sing this song Once For All, we're not just singing a bunch of empty words, but we're singing about a God who loved us in spite of our sin, in spite of what we deserved. And so I want us to remember as we sing this song that God is for us, that there's absolutely nothing that can separate you from his love, and that when Jesus came and died on the cross for you, he defeated sin and he rescued us and delivered us once for all.
God is for us, who can stand against?